Good afternoon, Judy Steffes, broadcasting live from American Exchanger Services here on Wisconsin Avenue in Hartford. What you're watching now is a 200,000-pound steam condenser that's going to be used in a turbine in Cleveland, Ohio, and it is being loaded onto a 19-axle trailer. This trailer actually has two drivers, one up front and then one at the rear here. A lot of weights and measurements going to be going on, and then this is going to be pulling out early tomorrow morning and headed to Cleveland. The permits to get this on the road, according to the contractors, took over 6 weeks. And again, the reason for the live broadcast is because despite the inflation, the lack of materials, the employment issues, American Exchanger Services here in Hartford Industrial Park continues to be moving forward with manufacturing. And while we're getting this underway, Tom, can you join me here just for a minute?
Yes, hi Judy.
Yeah, hi. Watching this 19-axle vehicle. Have you seen this come before in Hartford, this kind of movement?
I have seen a rig like this on the highway, actually. I've not seen one in Hartford before, but this is certainly quite an experience to be here witnessing this. American Exchanger is the company that produced the large tank that you see hanging in the air right now. It's going to be loaded on the trailer for movement to a customer in Ohio. This is so large and the metal is so thick. The tank weighs over 200,000 pounds. And American Exchanger uses a process called explosion welding in order to bond the various pieces of metal together. When they do it, various businesses in the area have to be notified that they will be hearing explosions throughout the period of 2 or 3 hours, so that there's no concern that some sort of an emergency is taking place. Great company, American Exchanger. We're really happy to have them here in Hartford, and we wish them continued success. This is a huge project.
They bid on this about a year ago, is what they were saying. Mm-hmm. And finally coming to fruition, a lot of U.S. suppliers, some overseas.
Certainly the state of manufacturing in America in particular, but in Hartford specifically, is just great. All of our businesses are experiencing a remarkable recovery from the pandemic, and we are experiencing a lot of employment issues. Workforce is a major issue for everybody these days, and a number of our employers have help wanted signs out looking for people to respond to their customers' increase in business levels.
So what they're doing, they explained before, they're pulling the rig out onto, is that Wacker Drive?
That is Wacker Drive.
And then they are going to back it into this building here and then pull it back forward and drop this 200,000-pound condenser into the rig. And then they have weights and measurements come in order to make sure it's safe.
Right.
Am I right?
There are a number of state inspections that have to be done yet, including some that will be done tomorrow morning, we understand. And then this entire rig will be on the road tomorrow evening about 8 o'clock with police escort.
They were here earlier today. They said some of the things that they can't travel through Milwaukee between, well, rush hour, I'm sure, in the morning. But this isn't something you can pull into an off-ramp and just wait it out, or into the Walmart parking lot.
You're right, Judy. Yep.
which is a 40-foot long, 200,000-pound steam condenser. It's going to go into a turbine and help generate electricity. Are they setting that right on top or inside?
No, no, it'll go inside. They got to lower it down and then, whoops, sorry.
You're all right.
They'll move it back so it sits inside the cradle.
Okay.
Remember I was telling you how we got them double beams on the floor?
Uh-huh.
And it'll adjust there.
And why did they put those shims in, you said?
Well, we wanted to get some more. When we dropped this in here, I think it's like right at 190,000, I think. But the weight on it, you see the bow and the load? And yep. We have to be able to keep that bow, but the reason why you shim it up is so it doesn't push us down so far. So when you're going over the road, like when you go over the road and you got to go over like the hump.
Sure.
We got to make sure we got enough clearance so we don't gouge the road. We're not looking to damage it.
Yeah. How long will this take to get it to Cleveland then? A couple days or?
Hopefully by Friday.
All right.
That's when we get it. We got to do an inspection tomorrow morning. Then you'll turn around from there. We can't leave until nighttime, but then we can't go in any other state at night. So. When something like this, your biggest problem is you have to be able to park at night. You can only run from sunup to sundown. So it takes up six spaces at semi spots when you go to like the rest area now.
You guys are making this look easy.
Not me. So we'll see when we get down the road.
And the rest of that trailer, if you're joining us late, is deep into this building. And it took two large cranes to pick that up and lower it down.